Hey guys, so I just recorded a look. I just recorded a video doing this look. And if you wanna see what I did to get this eye, continue watching. I feel weird, like I never do intros or outros. I get a little camera shy, but this deserved an intro. Yeah, so this is already set, primed, and all that other stuff. I'm gonna be using Morphe's 35B palette and this whole row is about to get used. But so I started with the darkest green. And once again, I'm looking into this mirror, so this is what I'm looking over here. First, I'm gonna be patting it on with, like, in a C shape, because this is like really patchy. So yeah, it took me forever to build the color up in the first eye. And then going in with this shade. Ooh, let me just keep this into my life. Going in with this shade, I'm gonna soften it up a little bit. The same brush. Next, I'm gonna cut my crease using LA Girl Pro Conceal and Fawn. Now with my Real Techniques brush, the deluxe crease brush, I'm just gonna pat and take away all the extra product that I don't need, and I don't want it to be too wet. And then with the same brush and no product, I'm gonna go back in and drag the green that we do have towards the end of the cut crease so that there isn't any harsh line. And then I'll bring it pretty close to the center of my lid. Now I'm gonna actually bring in some product, but I'm using the light green that we used. This one, once again. I'm just pressing that on. And I'm gonna use this small, precise brush. It's Morphe M507. And I'm gonna go in with the shimmer shade, the green shimmer. In the same row, so this one right here. This swatch is pretty good too, like it's like really like buttery. But yeah, I'm gonna use that and tap that in as well on the parts that are not covered already. And it's okay to bring it in towards the green, because you want everything to be like blended without any harsh lines. To finish up this eye look, I'm gonna go in with the Hunter Green Hunter Ink Eyeliner Gel by Bobbi Brown. I don't think you can see, but, and I'm not gonna do like a full wing. Like, you see, this one is like a half wing blended into the I'm nervous to do this on camera. Whew. So I'm just gonna dip and go towards the end. Let me make sure you guys can see me. Whew. Go towards the end. I'm gonna do a lot. I don't think you can see that. And then once again with the, can you guys see this? Once again, the same brush that I used from the beginning, all the way from the beginning. No product, I'm just gonna blend this eyeliner. Oh, I'm gonna use that brush. So yes, I'm gonna use the same eyeliner. And blend that into the outer V and up into the crease so that is seamless. I'm sorry, I'm getting sick, so and after that I'm just gonna apply lashes and do my inner corner, under eye, all that good stuff. But I'm so excited about these lashes that I'm about to wear because I need to clean this up. But yeah, I'm gonna moisturize my face first and then do my lashes so I can allow time for that to dry. My face was so dry. So for lashes, I'm wearing these from Juno & Co. These are so pretty and they were only $4. Like, what? So pretty and cheap and dramatic. These are so dramatic. Like, I can't even see the eye shadow. I don't know about you guys, but I really like this. I really do. And everything is gonna come together once I have my foundation and all of that together. Back to being a dry. I don't know if this is the same one I used before, but this is NARS Macau. I don't know how to say it, but So I'm gonna go back in with this brush and make sure there's nothing. Yeah, back in with this brush and go over all the parts that I highlighted, like around the ends, and make sure that it blends with the foundation. There's no harsh lines. I feel like I say harsh lines a lot, but it's true. I mean, you want to make sure you're not looking like, you know. And then like where my nose is at, my beauty blender is not like small enough to get into it. So I'll go back in with this concealer brush and fix those areas where I can't go. And then I'm also gonna set right under my eye. There's something else that I need. Contour. Going in with LA Girl Pro Conceal once again in Dark Cocoa. That's what I'm gonna use to contour. So I'm not a nose contour pro, so I'm gonna just go back in, cause this color is like really dark. I'm just gonna go back in with the same brush I've been using for my concealer, just to soften it up a little bit. This is probably like my third or fourth time contouring my nose, and I think I'm getting a little better. Like, my nose looks very slim. The part that I'm like struggling at is blending it perfectly. Next, my favorite part, highlight. And this is a new, well, this is not new, but this is a new one for me. Artist Couture Conceited. I've never used this before. But yeah, using it today. I'm scared. I see a lot of people drag their highlight like all the way down to their cheeks. And I kind of want to try it. I Yeah. Wow. Whew. And then I'm going to use from the Huda Beauty Sapphire Obsessions. I'm gonna use this one is like closer to green. And this swatch is so pretty. Wait. I think I'm gonna use that. My under eye. That hurts. Like, it's getting stuck in my eye. I feel like a ninja turtle. Woo! What am I missing? Lip gloss. How could I do that? Lip gloss is life. Trying to think, should I go with my Fenty Beauty? What is it called? Fenty Beauty lip gloss, the glow, the glitter one. But then I have to find it. So yes, this is Fenty Beauty's new Diamond Milk lip. And it's so pretty. Like, to me, it reminds me of, like, Bratz. Like, I feel like I'm a Bratz doll with it. Like. And it smells so good. But look how pretty this looks. I'm gonna take so much pictures today. And this highlighter though.